the first verse that whoever kills a soul, it's as if they killed the entire mankind. This is a major sin. It's a huge sin. This man killed 100 souls. Imagine. And he had not done one good deed in his life, or not one good virtuous act in his life, and yet Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala had mercy upon him because he had this intention to return or to ask for forgiveness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So he did not enter paradise because of any good deeds he did. He didn't have any. It's solely on the grace and the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And this is how pleasing it is to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that we turn back to him. The Prophet ﷺ mentioned in a hadith, Allah is more delighted with the repentance of his servant than one of you would be who suddenly finds his camel laden with supplies after losing it in a barren land. So if you're traveling in a desert and you have your camel with all these equipment and the water and the food and all your provisions, it gets lost. And you're stuck in the middle of the desert. And you give up hope. And then all of a sudden, after you're thinking you're going to die of starvation or die of thirst, your camel shows up with all the equipment. And just imagine the hope and the happiness and the delight that you may feel. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala feels more hope than this of the slave or the servant that turns back to him in repentance. So he wants us to come back to him. And the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam also said, If you did not commit sins, Allah would sweep you out of this earth, or He would replace you as a people, as a creation. He would get rid of all of us and replace us by another people who would commit the sins and then ask for Allah's forgiveness, and He would forgive them. So what does this mean? That Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He does not expect us to be perfect. He knows this is our nature, that we're going to fall into error. But what He's looking for is that we return back to Him and we ask Him His forgiveness. With that, brothers and sisters, I'd like to begin with a hadith Qudsi, and I'd like to get into the details of this, specifically on the topic of forgiveness.
عن أنس رضي الله عنه قال سمعت رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم يقول قال الله تبارك وتعالى يا ابن آدم إنك ما دعوتني ورجوتني غفرت لك على ما كان منك ولا أبالي يا ابن آدم لو بلغت ذنوبك عنان السماء ثم استغفرتني غفرت لك ولا أبالي يا ابن آدم إنك لو أتيتني بقراب الأرض خطايا ثم لقيتني لا تشرك بي شيئا لأتيتك بقرابها مغفرة رواه الترمذي وقال حديث حسن صحيح.
This is a hadith Qudsi, meaning this is the statement of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala as He gave it to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam.
And the authority of Anas, may Allah be pleased with him, who said, I heard the Messenger of Allah, blessings of Allah and peace be upon him, say, Allah the Blessed, the Most High, said, O son of Adam, meaning he is addressing every single human being. O son of Adam, as long as you call upon me and put your hope in me, I have forgiven you for what you have done and I do not mind. As long as we come back to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and we put our hope in him and we ask of him, he will forgive us and he does not mind. O son of Adam, if your sins were to reach the clouds of the sky, and then you would seek my forgiveness, I would forgive you. O son of Adam, if you were to come to me with sins that are close to filling the earth, and you would then meet me without ascribing any partners with me, I would certainly also bring to you forgiveness close to the filling of the earth. This is recorded by Tirmidhi, and it said, is a Hasan Sahih Hadith.